Chris Cole came on here and said that Mike Mo has the best quote ever. It's, I'd rather get caught jerking off than caught checking my MySpace.
Oh, now? Yeah, that's what. Yeah, he always says that. He like brings it up to me like once a month for some reason.
He loves that quote.
And I'm like, you know what? It's not that fucking funny.
It is. It's kind of funny.
It's funny, yeah, but maybe
you
not
hear it every month. Yeah.
So we got Mike Mo here with his newly destroyed leg.
Destroyed.
Resting on my lap. What happened?
I was telling him, I'm like, dude, should I tell the real story? It's embarrassing, man.
You
like,
have to tell the real story.
I know, that's what I was saying. Like, it comes a time and I'm always just completely honest about everything. So I figure why would I change it this time? But it was at Woodward, right?
Okay.
And I wasn't skating, of course, you know. So I was driving a golf cart. And, you know, we were being wild, you know, but the thing is, we were being wild in the zones to be wild in, you know, like, I was in the dirt field or whatever, and I was just, like, doing donuts and having fun or whatever, and that, you know, that's what everyone does, you know, so that was normal, and then I get on the pathway to go to the other side of camp, and it was super dark on the pathway, and I didn't see where the fuck I was going. It basically just had a drop-off into a skate park, and it was, like, probably a 5-foot drop. It was, like, this tall.
Oh, God.
And I fucking just saw it last second and just off the side and boom, just smashed to the fucking side. Like, it was one of those 6-seater carts too, so it was like.
Did you try to catch the thing with your leg or something?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Like, I was in full, like, Batman mode. I was just trying to, like, fucking save everyone. I was hanging on for dear life. And I, like, if it was just
me
in the cart.
There was five other people in there? Or
yeah, like, and if it was me just driving the fucking cart, I would have fucking just bailed out, you know what I mean? Yeah. And let the cart fucking go to hell. But, you know, I'm the driver. I can't fucking have everyone else fucking die because of me, you know? So I fucking hung on for dear life. I was just trying to do everything I could to fucking save it. And I fucking just flew off the edge and I stuck my leg out because I was like trying to save the fucking car. I could just doing whatever to fucking save it, you know? And I fucking land and my leg snaps completely sideways. Like, it was fucking like, say it's my left one. And I fucking put my foot out and it just like that, fully sideways. Like, my heel was touching my right knee.
So did you think it was a sprain at first or what?
Yeah, I'm like, you know, I'll probably be back skating in like, you know, 6 to 8 weeks, I'm all good, you know? No, but I fucking snapped the thing out and I fucking instantly was just like, I snapped my fucking leg and I grabbed it and gosh, and fucking put it back together like a Lego piece, you know what I mean? Like, it was like,
fucking,
you know, you see people
like
do that
crazy
with their finger?
Yeah, Eldridge or whatever did that with his hand, remember?
Yeah, yeah, imagine that, but a fucking knee. You know what I mean? Like,
get fucked.
Like, dude, like, look at the size difference. You know what I mean?
Wait, how long? how long between the slam to the pop back in did you wait? Was it like 30 seconds or right?
3 seconds, probably. It was out, and just put it back.
You watch too many fucking
movies, man. What hurt more,
the
first bending or the popping it out or popping it in?
I wouldn't say, I don't know. I don't think either one really hurt that bad. Just because you're in shock, you know, you can't really fucking feel something that crazy. Like, you can't believe it. You're looking down and you're like, my leg is this way.
Oh my God.
And it just instinct though. I just bah, fucking put it back. Didn't even fucking, didn't hesitate, didn't think about it. It was just like, bah. It just, it wasn't right. I had to.
What about the other kids? Were there just bodies everywhere?
That's what is also mind-blowing about this, because that was a real slam. It wasn't like a fucking, like, oh, you know, just like a little tiny accident. It was like a fucking gnarly thing
car
that
crash
happened, you know? So I'm lucky that nobody else got hurt, because if I did this to someone else or something, I would have fucking been devastated. I'm still devastated, but like, if I did this to someone else, I'd be so fucking way more bummed than I already am, you know? At least it was like, it is my fault.
Yeah.
But like you were saying in the car over here, it's like, it could have gone worse, but it also could
have, like,
not happened. So, you know, whichever way you want to look at it.
Vehicular manslaughter or something, you know, on it.
Yeah, I could have fucked somebody up, dude. Yeah. I could, and I got 6 staples in my head to add to it. By the way, I tore all 4 ligaments.
Yeah.
ACL, PCL, LCL, MCL. They're all fucked up. And I fractured my fibula. And then, since I dislocated this way, this is where the nerve is on in your knee.
Mm-hmm.
And my ankle is numb and it doesn't move right now. So it's like my ankle, I got an ankle injury because I fucked my knee up so bad, you know?
Yeah. Well, there was impact too, right?
Like, oh, totally. Yeah.
Jeez.
So, but my toes are starting to wiggle.
Get those BPMs up.
Starting to wiggle, man.
Yeah.
Wiggle your big toe.
Do we call you Scott or do we call you Big Cat? What do people call you?
Both, man.
It's like 50-50.
What do you call them?
I call you both.
Yeah.
I did too.
Yeah. Did you know that he worked at Woodward?
Huh?
Do you know
he
worked at Woodward? East.
Yeah. When I was like 19.
What, summertime camps or something?
Yeah. I worked there for 2 years.
Would you just drive there from Ohio?
Yeah.
Is that how it would work?
Yeah, just like load up my car with a few boards and like shoes and shit and just drive out there.
Sick.
Like I went 1 year as a camper when I was 17 or 18. And then after that, the next 2 years I worked there.
We were just talking, we were at Starbucks talking. I used to see you pop up in like 401s and stuff back in the day, right?
Yeah, now and then.
Like you had like almost like a skate career going.
Dude,
like
he's gnarly, dude.
No, I know he's sick. Yeah. I know he's sick. But I'm trying to get like do the timeline of how you got to where you are now, because I know I'd seen you skating over the years.
Yeah, I mean, that's why I moved to LA. Yeah, all I wanted to do was skate. Like, they were filming the Alien video of Minefield, and they kind of told like, you know, like they flowed me boards and they flowed like Kevin Turpin boards and shit at the time too. And they kind of told both of us, and I think Jake Johnson, all those dudes, whoever the like flow guys were, they kind of told us like, yeah, if you can film a video part worth being in the video, then like,
then you're in.
We'll put you in the video. And I think there was like 6 months or so, maybe a little more left until like the, whatever the deadline was. And I fucking broke my neck, couldn't skate for like months. You know what I mean? So I was kind of like, well, that was the last shot at that.
Oh, so that,
because by then I was like, I was like 25, you know, like towards the end of like where you're gonna like do it or you're not.
Yeah. So were you hooked up when you were younger by anybody, or were you just always flow for, or on Alien or whatever?
Because
I saw footage of you shredding the Kettering Plaza. Like your old footage.
Yeah, I mean, it's weird. Like DC and Alien, from the time I was really young, would always just send me shit just because of Rob ended up being my cousin. Like, I went down to Alien when I was like 17. Like me and my brother. And my brother had like a zero board or some shit, and Chris Carter, who owns a workshop, was like, what are you riding?
what is that thing?
He's like, I don't know. Like, yeah, he's like, I don't, you know, my brother was probably 13 at the time. He's like, I don't know. Like, and I guess he just asked Rob, he's like, did they buy boards?
Yeah.
And he was like, yeah, I don't know. Like, he's like, why don't you just tell him to call and get boards? Like, why would they buy skateboards?
Yeah.
Like they've always, I don't know, they've just always been so cool about like taking care or whatever. But okay, like I don't want to just be like this dude who's like Rob's cousin and just like, oh, he's just DC and Alien and like everything. Yeah, Rob. Yeah. So it was like, okay, like I'll get you some DBS for a while to just kind of like at least like set myself off a little bit to where it's like, just okay, you're not just getting hooked up because you're this dude's cousin, like, you know.
What was the story you were telling me?
I didn't realize until I figured this out, and I forgot to bring it up to you at the fucking the last Street League run. That switch tray, the San Pedro.
Dude, I was about to talk about that.
Yeah,
switch tray, that thing.
I went there with Eric. We were costing to film it for a fucking one of his last tricks, I think.
Costin was trying it?
Costin was trying it, and then I went there with Tave to fucking do it. He wanted to try to do it, and then we saw that came out, and we were like, fuck, dude, we're all bummed. And I just put it together that's you.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Like I saw it, I'm like, get the fuck, because I know you're good, but I didn't think like.
No, switch tray, that thing's fucked up.
That's fucked up.
No, that's fucked up.
It's 5'5". Yeah, it's insane.
You Instagrammed it like a couple months ago, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Go check his Instagram, @BigCat, dude.
Maybe that's what it was. I saw it on something.
Do a lot of people assume you don't skate? Because you're like, you're in the skate world, but you're not like a skater.
No, not really. Because I think like, you know, like him and Mikey, like those, they all know I skate because I skated with them long before.
Yeah, like, I just mean like for more like kids out there, like who's this guy, blah, 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 blah.
Yeah, I don't know. I haven't gotten hate for it, but I definitely get like every now and then like, oh shit, like I didn't know you skated.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know.
Well, not only like that you skate, you fucking switch tray a 5'5". That's fucking insane.
Everyone sees him skating, he's good.
But switch tray that thing, that's real shit, you know? That's
there's
real.
Nothing anyone can say that's like there's no validity anywhere towards you not being a full-fledged skater first, and then whatever the fuck the show and all that stuff puts on afterwards is obviously secondary to it all. Or it was at the beginning, maybe it's
taking. He just skates because kids like it. Like, no, this motherfucker switched straight to 5'5".
Well, you see a lot of it now with all the celebrities like trying to skate here or there, and it's like, no.
Yeah, no, this fucker switched trade a 5'5".
Just keep on running. Just loop that thing as a sound. Exactly.
Hey, how'd you get the judging job for Street League?
No, I think like Rob and whoever just wanted the judges to be like younger dudes who still skate all the time and like understand modern skateboarding.
Yeah.
So, and how much flack do you catch for doing that stuff?
A lot of kids lately, because I think they're just trying to pick apart something to why Nyjah keeps winning. So it's like, oh, you overscore him and like this and that. It's like, He said it's like, no way.
On the way here, it's like, dude, those are fucking accurate, man. Those are accurate fucking scores, man.
And I told him, it's like, if in, like, saying we overscore Nyjah, A, doesn't, like, why we would cheat it to have Nyjah, of all people, win doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, you know like, I mean? Like, anything, you'd be, it doesn't have anything to do with him,
it's
like,
it's a Nike contest, so why would we cheat it for a DC dude? Yeah. You know what I mean?
Like, yeah. Or why cheat it to have the same guy win over and over?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It doesn't make any sense.
It's like, and he's just that fucking good that he is getting, like, 9-2s every time or whatever.
And
it's
he's
like,
coming from behind a lot, too.
Yeah, like, almost every one is like...
he's fucking taking that run with it. I saw his eyes perk up.
Whoa. I was waiting for you to fucking put it on me.
Fucker. I see what happened. You pointed right at me. Your nipples got perky through your Abercrombie and Fitch shirt. Your eyebrows went up. You're all fucking checking Tinder. I saw what you were about to do.
Jesus. How do I catch all this shrapnel? We're talking about judging.
Oh, sorry. Sorry, anyways. Back to Nyjah coming from behind. No, but, like, that stuff, I look at it, and I get people to ask me the questions, or they ask me all the time, like, dude, what's up with the judging on that shit? And I'm like, dude, it's... First of all, you can't possibly claim it's rigged because there's five of you?
Five.
And they're all doing your own score, and they drop the lowest and drop the highest, right?
Yeah. So if somebody's like... Somebody's like, favoring someone, like, you're getting dropped anyways.
Yeah, anyway, yeah.
Or if you're hating on somebody, yeah, you're getting dropped, you know, dropped.
So it's like, but that, I look at it as a difficult task because there's certain times in these contests where it's like, you guys are fucking, look, this dude's gonna bust something gnarly, and you, and the whole crowd is like, they're voting for their favorite in spirit, not in, you guys have to stay on the dial.
Yeah.
You can't let the crowd affect what you're fucking doing, basically.
Yeah, and I always try to ignore, like, if they are kind of saying, like, what someone needs to be here, I always try to ignore that. And I know that I've told those dudes, too, and I know they do. Like, they just kind of block it out. So, because you don't want to, like, think of it that way.
Bias.
You know, yeah,
what,
like.
What about how, like, we had Chaz and maybe someone else, you said, maybe you said it.
I have said it to them,
the judges shouldn't watch practice.
I said, I've said it.
Because then a certain trick might not have the same effect on you when you see it in the finals. Like, do you agree with that?
No, I don't. Because if anything, the only thing that not watching the practice is going to do is going to either boost or lower the way stuff scores in the beginning before you can really see how everybody's skating the course. Mm-hmm. Like, the way practice goes is kind of, you kind of gauge, like, what sets the bar. You know what I mean? Like, for example, like, in the LA one, that weird bar that Ashad from Type People Grinded or whatever.
Insane, yeah.
Yeah, like, he did that towards the beginning of the contest. And so it's like, had nobody watched practice and nobody watched anybody else, like, hop up on that thing at least, like, we could have, like, maybe downplayed it, like, oh, well, what if someone does something hard, you know, like, kind of leaving that room. And it's
insane.
Like,
insane. That makes so much sense. Yeah.
It's like the practice kind of sets the bar to where you're not getting caught off guard in the beginning, you know?
Because there's
the other side.
No one touched it. Yeah. Not, I didn't ever thought of your guys' side. Selfish is what Rob tells me.
How long did you skate in Street League? Was it just the first season?
No, I was in for 3 years.
But did you skate in all? There were a bunch you didn't even skate.
I was hurt. I was hurt for the first one. I did my best. I could, like, only skate the ledge. Yeah, I couldn't take any impact for the whole first year. Second year, I did okay. And then third year was just like, I didn't do that good. They actually, you know what happened? The third year, they had like a, because you guys do the lines now.
Yeah.
So the lines, it's like, I can't land fucking 3 tricks in a row. I can't land 4 tricks in a row. You know what I mean? Like, so I can't fucking do that.
At,
like,
that point, because you...
There, so that whole format just fucked me.
There was a contract, right? So
yeah.
At that point, are you like, maybe you should give this spot to someone else? Or, like, how does it... How do you
not
get renewed?
No, I would have held on to it for selfish reasons. Yeah. But no, I got kicked out.
Full battle.
Do you guys ever set up the seamless in the garage and get all, like, nudie photos on each other?
No.
They got penis everything.
Yeah, what is that?